This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Uranium is a chemical element with symbol U and atomic number. Is also important in nuclear technology. Uranium-238 has a small probability for spontaneous fission or even induced fission with fast neutrons. Uranium-235 and to a lesser degree uranium-233 have a much higher fission cross-section for slow neutrons in sufficient concentration. These isotopes maintain a sustained nuclear chain reaction. This generates the heat in nuclear power reactors, and produces the fissile material for nuclear weapons. Depleted uranium-238 U is used in kinetic energy penetrators and armor plating. Uranium is used as a colorant in uranium glass, producing lemon yellow to green colors. Uranium glass fluoresces green in ultraviolet light. It was also used for tinting and shading in early photography. The 1789 discovery of uranium in the mineral pitchblende is credited to Martin Heinrich Klaproth, who named the new element after the planet Uranus. Eugene Melchior Peligo was the first person to isolate the metal, and its radioactive properties were discovered in 1896 by Henri Becquerel. Research by Otto Hahn, Lise Meitner, Enrico Fermi and others, such as J. Robert Oppenheimer starting in 1934 led to its use as a fuel in the nuclear power industry and in Little Boy, the first nuclear weapon used in war and ensuing arms race during the Cold War between the United States and the Soviet Union produced tens of thousands of nuclear weapons that used uranium metal and uranium-derived plutonium-239. The security of those weapons and their fissile material following the breakup of the Soviet Union in 1991 is an ongoing concern for public health and safety. See nuclear proliferation. Contents 1. Characteristics 2. Applications 21. Military 22. Civilian 3. History 31. Pre-discovery use 32. Discovery 33. Fission research 34. Nuclear weaponry 35. Reactors 36. Prehistoric naturally occurring fission 37. Contamination and the Cold War legacy 4. Occurrence 41. Biotic and abiotic 42. Production and mining 43. Resources and reserves 44. Supplies 5. Compounds 51. Oxidation states and oxides 511. Oxides 512. Aqueous chemistry 513. Carbonates 514. Effects of pH 52. Hydrides, carbides and nitrides 53. Halides 6. Isotopes 61. Natural concentration 62. Enrichment 7. Human exposure 71. Effects and precautions 8. See also 9. Notes 10. References 11. External links. Characteristics: a neutron-induced nuclear fission event involving uranium-235 when refined. Uranium is a silvery-white, weakly radioactive metal. It has a Mohs hardness of 6, sufficient to scratch glass and approximately equal to that of titanium, rhodium, manganese and niobium. It is malleable, ductile, slightly paramagnetic, strongly electropositive and a poor electrical conductor. Uranium metal has a very high density of 191. Explosion in a nuclear reactor, such a chain reaction is slowed and controlled by a neutron poison, absorbing some of the free neutrons. Such neutron absorbent materials are often part of reactor control rods. See nuclear reactor physics for a description of this process of reactor control as little as 15. The major application of uranium in the military sector is in high-density penetrators. This ammunition consists of depleted uranium-2 alloyed with 1-2% other elements, such as titanium or molybdenum at high impact speed. The density, hardness, and pyrophoricity of the projectile enable the destruction of heavily armored targets. Tank armor and other removable vehicle armor can also be hardened with depleted uranium plates. The use of depleted uranium became politically and environmentally contentious after the use of such munitions by the US, UK and other countries during wars in the Persian Gulf and the Balkans raised questions concerning uranium compounds left in the soil. See Gulf War Syndrome. Depleted uranium is also used as a shielding material in some containers used to store and transport radioactive materials. While the metal itself is radioactive, its high density makes it more effective than lead in halting radiation from strong sources such as radium. Other uses of depleted uranium include counterweights for aircraft control surfaces, as ballast for missile re-entry vehicles and as a shielding material due to its high density. This material is found in inertial guidance systems and in gyroscopic compasses. Depleted uranium is preferred over similarly dense metals due to its ability to be easily machined and cast as well as its relatively low cost. The main risk of exposure to depleted uranium is chemical poisoning by uranium oxide rather than radioactivity. Uranium being only a weak alpha emitter. During the later stages of World War II, the entire Cold War, and to a lesser extent afterwards, uranium-235 has been used as the fissile explosive material to produce nuclear weapons initially. Two major types of fission bombs were built, a relatively simple device that uses uranium-235 and a more complicated mechanism that uses plutonium-239 derived from uranium-238 later, a much more complicated and far more powerful type of fission-fusion bomb thermonuclear weapon was built, that uses a plutonium-based device to cause a mixture of tritium and deuterium to undergo nuclear fusion. Such bombs are jacketed in a non-fissile unenriched uranium case, and they derive more than half their power from the fission of this material by fast neutrons from the nuclear fusion process. Civilian. The most visible civilian use of uranium is as the thermal power source used in nuclear power plants. The main use of uranium in the civilian sector is to fuel nuclear power plants. 1 kilogram of uranium-235 can theoretically produce about 20. In uranium-235, the exact values are classified in a breeder reactor. Uranium-238 can also be converted into plutonium through the following reaction: 238-92 UN 239-92 U gamma beta minus. Black, blue, red and other colors. Uranium glass used as lead in seals in a vacuum capacitor. Uranium was also used in photographic chemicals, especially uranium nitrate as a toner, in lamp filaments for stage lighting bulbs to improve the appearance of dentures, and in the leather and wood industries for stains and dyes. Uranium salts are mordants of silk or wool. Uranyl acetate and uranyl formate are used as electron dense stains in transmission electron microscopy to increase the contrast of biological specimens in ultrathin sections and in negative staining of viruses, isolated cell organelles and macromolecules. The discovery of the radioactivity of uranium ushered in additional scientific and practical uses of the element. The long half-life of the isotope uranium-238 451 × 109 years makes it well suited for use in estimating the age of the earliest igneous rocks and for other types of radiometric dating, including uranium-thorium dating, uranium-lead dating and uranium-uranium dating. Uranium metal is used for X-ray targets in the making of high-energy X-rays. History. Pre-discovery use. The planet Uranus, which uranium is named after, the use of uranium in its natural oxide form dates back to at least the year 79 CE, when it was used to add a yellow color to ceramic glazes. Yellow glass with 1% uranium oxide was found in a Roman villa on Cape Posillipo in the Bay of Naples, Italy, by R.T. Gunther of the University of Oxford in 1912. Starting in the late Middle Ages, pitchblende was extracted from the Habsburg silver mines in Joachimsthal, Bohemia, now Yakimov, in the Czech Republic, and was used as a coloring agent in the local glassmaking industry in the early 19th century. The world's only known sources of uranium ore were these mines. Discovery. Antoine-Henri Becquerel discovered the phenomenon of radioactivity by exposing a photographic plate to uranium in 1896. The discovery of the element is credited to the German chemist Martin Heinrich Klaproth while he was working in his experimental laboratory in Berlin in 1789. Klaproth was able to precipitate a yellow compound, likely sodium diuronate, by dissolving pitchblende in nitric acid and neutralizing the solution with sodium hydroxide. Klaproth assumed the yellow substance was the oxide of a yet undiscovered element and heated it with charcoal to obtain a black powder, which he thought was the newly discovered metal itself. In fact, that powder was an oxide of uranium. He named the newly discovered element after the planet Uranus, named after the primordial Greek god of the sky, which had been discovered 8 years earlier by William Herschel in 1841. Eugene Melchior Peligo, professor of analytical chemistry at the Conservatoire National des Arts at Metiers Central School of Arts and Manufactures in Paris, isolated the first sample of uranium metal by heating uranium tetrachloride with potassium. Henri Becquerel discovered radioactivity by using uranium in 1896. Becquerel made the discovery in Paris by leaving a sample of a uranium salt, K2UO2SO42 potassium uranyl sulfate, on top of an unexposed photographic plate in a drawer and noting that the plate had become fogged. He determined that a form of invisible light or rays emitted by uranium had exposed the plate. Fission research. Cubes and cuboids of uranium produced during the Manhattan Project. A team led by Enrico Fermi in 1934 observed that bombarding uranium with neutrons produces the emission of beta rays, electrons or positrons, from the elements produced. See beta particle. The fission products were at first mistaken for new elements of atomic numbers 93 and 94, which the dean of the Faculty of Rome, Orso Mario Corbino, christened Ausonium and Hesperium, respectively. The experiments leading to the discovery of uranium's ability to fission break apart into lighter elements and release binding energy were conducted by Otto Hahn and Fritz Strassmann in Hahn's laboratory in Berlin. Lise Meitner and her nephew, the physicist Otto Robert Frisch, published the physical explanation in February 1939 and named the process nuclear fission. Soon after, Fermi hypothesized that the fission of uranium might release enough neutrons to sustain a fission reaction. Confirmation of this hypothesis came in 1939, and later work found that on average about 25 neutrons are released by each fission of the rare uranium isotope uranium-235. Further work found that the far more common uranium-238 isotope can be transmuted into plutonium, which, like uranium-235, is also fissile by thermal neutrons. These discoveries led numerous countries to begin working on the development of nuclear weapons and nuclear power. On 2 December 1942, as part of the Manhattan Project, another team led by Enrico Fermi was able to initiate the first artificial self-sustained nuclear chain reaction, Chicago Pile 1. Working in a lab below the stands of Stagg Field at the University of Chicago, the team created the conditions needed for such a reaction by piling together 400 and a plutonium-based device, see Trinity Test and Fat Man, whose plutonium was derived from uranium-238. The uranium-based Little Boy device became the first nuclear weapon used in war when it was detonated over the Japanese city of Hiroshima on 6 August 1945, exploding with a yield equivalent to 12,500. Facility. Later, the town of Arco became the first in the world to have all its electricity come from nuclear power generated by Borax 3, another reactor designed and operated by Argonne National Laboratory, the world's first commercial-scale nuclear power station. Obninsk in the Soviet Union began generation with its reactor AM-1 on 27 June 1954. Other early nuclear power plants were Calder Hall in England, which began generation on 17 October 1956, and the Shippingport Atomic Power Station in Pennsylvania, which began on 26 May 1958. Nuclear power was used for the first time for propulsion by a submarine, the USS Nautilus, in 1954. Prehistoric naturally occurring fission. Main article, Natural Nuclear Fission Reactor. In 1972, the French physicist Francis Perrin discovered 15 ancient and no longer active natural nuclear fission reactors in three separate ore deposits at the Oklo mine in Gabon, West Africa. Collectively known as the Oklo fossil reactors, the ore deposit is 17 billion years old. Then, uranium-235 constituted about 3% of the total uranium on Earth. This is high enough to permit a sustained nuclear fission chain reaction to occur, provided other supporting conditions exist. The capacity of the surrounding sediment to contain the nuclear waste products has been cited by the U.S. federal government as supporting evidence for the feasibility to store spent nuclear fuel at the Yucca Mountain Nuclear Waste Repository. Contamination and the Cold War Legacy. U.S. and USSR, Russian nuclear weapons stockpiles, 1945-2005. Above-ground nuclear tests by the Soviet Union and the United States in the 1950s and early 1960s and by France into the 1970s and 1980s spread a significant amount of fallout from uranium daughter isotopes around the world. Additional fallout and pollution occurred from several nuclear accidents. Uranium miners have a higher incidence of cancer and excess risk of lung cancer among Navajo uranium miners, for example, has been documented and linked to their occupation. The Radiation Exposure Compensation Act, a 1990 law in the USA, required $100,000 in compassion payments to uranium miners diagnosed with cancer or other respiratory ailments during the Cold War between the Soviet Union and the United States. Huge stockpiles of uranium were amassed and tens of thousands of nuclear weapons were created using enriched uranium and plutonium made from uranium. Since the breakup of the Soviet Union in 1991, an estimated 600. 1993-2005. The Material Protection, Control, and Accounting Program, operated by the federal government of the United States, spent approximately US$550 million to help safeguard uranium and plutonium stockpiles in Russia. This money was used for improvements and security enhancements at research and storage facilities. Scientific American reported in February 2006 that in some of the facilities' security consisted of chain-link fences which were in severe states of disrepair. According to an interview from the article, one facility had been been storing samples of enriched weapons-grade uranium in a broom closet before the improvement project, another had been keeping track of its stock of nuclear warheads using index cards kept in a shoe box occurrence biotic and abiotic main article. Uranium in the environment. Uraninite, also known as pitchblende, is the most common ore mined to extract uranium. The evolution of Earth's radiogenic heat flow over time, contribution from 235 U in red and from 238 U in green. Uranium is a naturally occurring element that can be found in low levels within all rock, soil, and water. Uranium is the 51st element in order of abundance in the Earth's crust. Uranium is also the highest numbered element to be found naturally in significant quantities on Earth, and is almost always found combined with other elements along with all elements having atomic weights higher than that of iron. It is only naturally formed in supernovae. The decay of uranium, thorium, and potassium-40 in the Earth's mantle is thought to be the main source of heat that keeps the outer core liquid and drives mantle convection, which in turn drives plate tectonics. Uranium's average concentration in the Earth's crust is depending on the reference 2 to 4 parts per million, or about 40 times as abundant as silver. The Earth's crust from the surface to 25. Citrobacter species can have concentrations of uranium in their bodies 300 times the level of the surrounding environment. Some bacteria, such as Schwannella putrefaciens, Geobacter metalliriducens, and some strains of Burkholderia fungorum, use uranium for their growth and convert UVI to UIV. Some organisms, such as the lichen Trapelia involuta or microorganisms such as the bacterium Citrobacter, can absorb concentrations of uranium that are up to 300 times the level of their environment. Citrobacter species absorb uranyl ions when given glycerol phosphate or other similar organic phosphates after 1 day. 1 gram of bacteria can encrust themselves with 9 grams of uranyl phosphate crystals. This creates the possibility that these organisms could be used in bioremediation to decontaminate uranium-polluted water. The proteobacterium Geobacter has also been shown to bioremediate uranium in ground water. The mycorrhizal fungus Glomus intraradices increases uranium content in the roots of its symbiotic plant in nature. Uranium V forms highly soluble carbonate complexes at alkaline pH. This leads to an increase in mobility and availability of uranium to groundwater and soil from nuclear wastes, which leads to health hazards. However, it is difficult to precipitate uranium as phosphate in the presence of excess carbonate at alkaline pH. A Sphingomonas sp strain BSAR1 has been found to express a high activity alkaline phosphatase folk that has been applied for bioprecipitation of uranium as uranyl phosphate species from alkaline solutions. The precipitation ability was enhanced by overexpressing folk protein in E. coli. Plants absorb some uranium from soil. Dry weight concentrations of uranium in plants range from 5 to 60 parts per billion, and ash from burnt wood can have concentrations up to 4 parts per million. Dry weight concentrations of uranium in food. Plants are typically lower, with 1 to 2 micrograms per day ingested through the food people eat. Production and mining. Main article: uranium mining. World uranium production. Mines and demand. Yellowcake is a concentrated mixture of uranium oxides that is further refined to extract pure uranium. Worldwide production of U308 yellowcake in 2013 amounted to 70,015 tons, of which 22,451 t 32% was mined in Kazakhstan. Other important uranium mining countries are Canada 9,331 t, Australia 6,350 t, Niger 4,518 t, Namibia 4,323 t, and Russia 3,135 t. Uranium ore is mined in several ways: by open pit, underground, in situ leaching, and borehole mining. See uranium mining. Low-grade uranium ore mined typically contains 0.01 to 0.25% uranium oxides. Extensive measures must be employed to extract the metal from its ore. High-grade ores found in Athabasca Basin deposits in Saskatchewan, Canada can contain up to 23%. Uranium oxides. On average, uranium ore is crushed and rendered into a fine powder and then leached with either an acid or alkali. The leachate is subjected to one of several sequences of precipitation, solvent extraction, and ion exchange. The resulting mixture, called yellowcake, contains at least 75% uranium oxides. U308 yellowcake is then calcined to remove impurities from the milling process before refining and conversion. Commercial grade uranium can be produced through the reduction of uranium halide solids with alkali or alkaline earth metals. Uranium metal can also be prepared through electrolysis of KuF5 or UF4, dissolved in molten calcium chloride 2, and sodium chloride solution. Very pure uranium is produced through the thermal decomposition of uranium halides on a hot filament. Resources and reserves. It is estimated that 55 million tons of uranium exists in ore reserves that are economically viable at US$59 per pound of uranium, while 35 million tons are classed as mineral resources. Reasonable prospects for eventual economic extraction. Prices went from about $10 per pound in May 2003 to $138 per pound in July 2007. This has caused a big increase in spending on exploration, with US$200 million being spent worldwide in 2005, a 54% increase on the previous year. This trend continued through 2006, when expenditure on exploration rocketed to over $774 million, an increase of over 250% compared to 2004. The OECD Nuclear Energy Agency said exploration figures for 2007 would likely match those for 2006. Australia has 31% of the world's known uranium ore reserves and the world's largest single uranium deposit, located at the Olympic Dam mine in South Australia. There is a significant reserve of uranium in Bakouma, a sub-prefecture in the prefecture of Mbeomu in Central African Republic. Some nuclear fuel comes from nuclear weapons being dismantled, such as from the Megadons to Megawatts program. An additional 46 billion tons of uranium are estimated to be in sea water. Japanese scientists in the 1980s showed that extraction of uranium from sea water using ion exchangers was technically feasible. There have been experiments to extract uranium from sea water, but the yield has been low due to the carbonate present in the water. In 2012, ORNL researchers announced the successful development of a new absorbent material dubbed HICAP, which performs surface retention of solid or gas molecules, atoms or ions, and also effectively removes toxic metals from water, according to results verified by researchers at Pacific Northwest National Laboratory Supplies. This section needs to be updated. Please update this article to reflect recent events or newly available information. September 2016 main article, Uranium Market Monthly. Uranium spot price in US dollar per pound. The 2007 price peak is clearly visible. In 2005, 17 countries produced concentrated uranium oxides, with Canada 279% of world production and Australia 228% being the largest producers, and Kazakhstan 105%. Russia 80%, Namibia 75%, Niger 74%, Uzbekistan 55%, the United States 25%, Argentina 21%, Ukraine 19%, and China 17%. Also producing significant amounts. Kazakhstan continues to increase production and may have become the world's largest producer of uranium by 2009, with an expected production of 12,826. Decrease in ore grade. In other words, there is little high-grade ore and proportionately much more low-grade ore available. Compounds. Reactions of uranium metal oxidation. States and oxides. Oxides trioranium octoxide left and uranium dioxide right are the two most common uranium oxides. Calcined uranium yellowcake, as produced in many large mills, contains a distribution of uranium oxidation species in various forms, ranging from most oxidized to least oxidized. Particles with short residence times in a calciner will generally be less oxidized than those with long retention times, or particles recovered in the stack scrubber. Uranium content is usually referenced to U308, which dates to the days of the Manhattan Project, when U308 was used as an analytical chemistry reporting standard phase relationships in the uranium-oxygen system are complex. The most important oxidation states of uranium are uranium-Av and uranium-V, and their two corresponding oxides are, respectively, uranium dioxide UO2 and uranium trioxide UO3. Other uranium oxides such as uranium monoxide UO, diuranium pentoxide U2O5, and uranium peroxide UO42H2O also exist. The most common forms of uranium oxide are trioranium octoxide U308 and UO2. Both oxide forms are solids that have low solubility in water and are relatively stable over a wide range of environmental conditions. Trioranium octoxide oxide is, depending on conditions, the most stable compound of uranium and is the form most commonly found in nature. Uranium dioxide is the form in which uranium is most commonly used as a nuclear reactor fuel at ambient temperatures. UO2 will gradually convert to U3O8 because of their stability. Uranium oxides are generally considered the preferred chemical form for storage or disposal. Aqueous chemistry. Uranium in its oxidation states 3, IV, V, V salts. Of many oxidation states of uranium are water soluble and may be studied in aqueous solutions. The most common ionic forms are U3 brown red, U4 green, UO2 unstable, and UO22 yellow. For UIII, UIV, UV, and UVI, respectively, a few solid and semi-metallic compounds such as UO and US exist for the formal oxidation state uranium-y, but no simple ions are known to exist in solution for that state. Ions of U3 liberate hydrogen from water and are therefore considered to be highly unstable. The UO22 ion represents the uranium-V state and is known to form compounds such as uranyl carbonate, uranyl chloride, and uranyl sulfate. UO22 also forms complexes with various organic chelating agents, the most commonly encountered of which is uranyl acetate. Unlike the uranyl salts of uranium and polyatomic ion uranium oxide cationic forms, the uranates, salts containing a polyatomic uranium oxide anion, are generally not water-soluble carbonates. The interactions of carbonate anions with uranium-V cause the Pore-Bye diagram to change greatly when the medium is changed from water to a carbonate-containing solution. While the vast majority of carbonates are insoluble in water, students are often taught that all carbonates other than those of alkali metals are insoluble in water. Uranium carbonates are often soluble in water. This is because a UVI cation is able to bind two terminal oxides and three or more carbonates to form anionic complexes. Pore-Bye diagrams. Uranium in a non-complexing aqueous medium, e.g. perchloric acid, sodium hydroxide. Uranium in carbonate solution. Relative concentrations of the different chemical forms of uranium in a non-complexing aqueous medium, e.g. perchloric acid, sodium hydroxide. Relative concentrations of the different chemical forms of uranium in an aqueous carbonate solution. Effects of pH. The uranium fraction diagrams in the presence of carbonate illustrate this further. When the pH of a uranium-V solution increases, the uranium is converted to a hydrated uranium oxide hydroxide, and at high pHs it becomes an anionic hydroxide complex when carbonate is added. Uranium is converted to a series of carbonate complexes if the pH is increased. One effect of these reactions is increased solubility of uranium in the pH range 6 to 8, a fact that has a direct bearing on the long-term stability of spent uranium dioxide nuclear fuels. Hydrides, carbides, and nitrides. Uranium metal heated to 250 to 300. 3. Both UC and UC2 are formed by adding carbon to molten uranium or by exposing the metal to carbon monoxide at high temperatures stable below 1800. 6. Can form the intermediate fluorides of U2F9, U4F17, and UF5 at room temperatures. UF6 has a high vapor pressure, making it useful in the gaseous diffusion process to separate the rare uranium-235 from the common uranium-238 isotope. This compound can be prepared from uranium dioxide and uranium hydride by the following process: UO2-4-HF-UF42H2O500. The resulting UF6, a white solid, is highly reactive by fluorination, easily sublimes, emitting a vapor that behaves as a nearly ideal gas, and is the most volatile compound of uranium known to exist. One method of preparing uranium tetrachloride UCl4 is to directly combine chlorine with either uranium metal or uranium hydride. The reduction of UCl4 by hydrogen produces uranium trichloride UCl3, while the higher chlorides of uranium are prepared by reaction with additional chlorine. All uranium chlorides react with water, and air bromides and iodides of uranium are formed by direct reaction of, respectively, bromine and iodine with uranium or by adding U3 to those elements. Acids. Known examples include UBr3, UBr4, UI3, and UI4. Uranium oxyhalides are water soluble and include UO2F. 2UOCl2, UO2Cl2, and UO2Br2 stability of the oxyhalides decrease as the atomic weight of the component halide increases. Isotopes natural concentrations. Main article, isotopes of uranium. Natural uranium consists of three major isotopes, uranium-238 9928% natural abundance, uranium-235071%, and uranium-234-00054%. All three are radioactive, emitting alpha particles, with the exception that all three of these isotopes have small probabilities of undergoing spontaneous fission, rather than alpha emission. There are also five other trace isotopes, uranium-239, which is formed when 238U undergoes spontaneous fission, releasing neutrons that are captured by another 238U atom, uranium-237, which is formed when 238U captures a neutron but emits two more, which then decays to neptunium-237, and finally, uranium-233, which is formed in the decay chain of that neptunium-237. It is also expected that thorium-232 should be able to undergo double beta decay, which would produce uranium-232, but this has not yet been observed experimentally. Uranium-238 is the most stable isotope of uranium, with a half-life of about 4,468 times 109 years, roughly the age of the Earth. Uranium-235 has a half-life of about 713 times 108 years, and uranium-234 has a half-life of about 248 times 105 years for natural uranium. About 49% of its alpha rays are emitted by each of 238U atom, and also 49% by 234U, since the latter is formed from the former, and about 20% of them by the 235U when the Earth was young. Probably about one-fifth of its uranium was uranium-235, but the percentage of 234U was probably much lower than this. Uranium-238 is usually an alpha emitter. Occasionally, it undergoes spontaneous fission, decaying through the uranium series of nuclear decay, which has 18 members, into lead-206. By a variety of different decay paths, the decay series of 235U, which is called the actinium series, has 15 members and eventually decays into lead-207. The constant rates of decay in these decay series makes the comparison of the ratios of parent to daughter elements useful in radiometric dating. Uranium-234, which is a member of the uranium series, decays to lead-206 through a series of relatively short-lived isotopes. Uranium-233 is made from thorium-232 by neutron bombardment, usually in a nuclear reactor. And 233U is also fissile. Its decay series ends at bismuth-209 and thallium-205. Uranium-235 is important for both nuclear reactors and nuclear weapons, because it is the only uranium isotope existing in nature on Earth in any significant amount that is fissile. This means that it can be split into two or three fragments, fission products by thermal neutrons. Uranium-238 is not fissile, but is a fertile isotope, because after neutron activation it can produce plutonium-239, another fissile isotope indeed. The 238U nucleus can absorb one neutron to produce the radioactive isotope uranium-239. 239U decays by beta emission to neptunium-239, also a beta emitter, that decays in its turn, within a few days, into plutonium-239. 239 Pu was used as fissile material in the first atomic bomb detonated in the Trinity test on 15 July 1945 in New Mexico. Enrichment. Main article, enriched uranium. Cascades of gas centrifuges are used to enrich uranium ore to concentrate its fissionable isotopes in nature. Uranium is found as uranium-238-992,742% and uranium-235-07204%. Isotope separation concentrates enriches the fissionable uranium-235 for nuclear weapons and most nuclear power plants, except for gas-cooled reactors and pressurized heavy water reactors. Most neutrons released by a fissioning atom of uranium-235 must impact other uranium-235 atoms to sustain the nuclear chain reaction. The concentration and amount of uranium-235 needed to achieve this is called a critical mass to be considered enriched. The uranium-235 fraction should be between 3% and 5%. This process produces huge quantities of uranium that is depleted of uranium-235, and with a correspondingly increased fraction of uranium-235 238, called depleted uranium or DU, to be considered depleted, the uranium-235 isotope concentration should be no more than 0.3%. The price of uranium has risen since 2001, so enrichment tailings containing more than 0.35% uranium-235 are being considered for re-enrichment, driving the price of depleted uranium hexafluoride above $130 per kilogram in July 2007 from $5 in 2001. The gas centrifuge process, where gaseous uranium hexafluoride UF6 is separated by the difference in molecular weight between 235 UF6 and 238 UF6 using high-speed centrifuges, is the cheapest and leading enrichment process. The gaseous diffusion process had been the leading method for enrichment and was used in the Manhattan Project. In this process, uranium hexafluoride is repeatedly diffused through a silver-zinc membrane, and the different isotopes of uranium are separated by diffusion rate. Since uranium-238 is heavier, it diffuses slightly slower than uranium-235. The molecular laser isotope separation method employs a laser beam of precise energy to sever the bond between uranium-235 and fluorine. This leaves uranium-238 bonded to fluorine and allows uranium-235 metal to precipitate from the solution. An alternative laser method of enrichment is known as atomic vapor laser isotope separation, AVLIS, and employs visible tunable lasers such as dye lasers. Another method used is liquid thermal diffusion human exposure. A person can be exposed to uranium or its radioactive daughters, such as radon, by inhaling dust in air or by ingesting contaminated water and food. The amount of uranium in air is usually very small. However, people who work in factories that process phosphate fertilizers, live near government facilities that made or tested nuclear weapons, live or work near a modern battlefield where depleted uranium weapons have been used, or live or work near a coal-fired power plant, facilities that mine or process uranium ore, or enrich uranium for reactor fuel, may have increased exposure to uranium. Houses or structures that are over uranium deposits, either natural or man-made slag deposits, may have an increased incidence of exposure to radon gas. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration, OSHA, has set the permissible exposure limit for uranium exposure in the workplace as 0.25. Most ingested uranium is excreted during digestion. Only 0.5% is absorbed when insoluble forms of uranium, such as its oxide, are ingested, whereas absorption of the more soluble uranyl ion can be up to 5%. However, soluble uranium compounds tend to quickly pass through the body, whereas insoluble uranium compounds, especially when inhaled by way of dust into the lungs, pose a more serious exposure hazard after entering the bloodstream. The absorbed uranium tends to bioaccumulate and stay for many years in bone tissue because of uranium's affinity for phosphates. Uranium is not absorbed through the skin, and alpha particles released by uranium cannot penetrate the skin. Incorporated uranium becomes uranyl ions, which accumulate in bone, liver, kidney, and reproductive tissues. Uranium can be decontaminated from steel surfaces and aquifers. Effects and precautions. Normal functioning of the kidney, brain, liver, heart, and other systems can be affected by uranium exposure, because, besides being weakly radioactive, uranium is a toxic metal. Uranium is also a reproductive toxicant. Radiological effects are generally local because alpha radiation, the primary form of 238U decay, has a very short range, and will not penetrate skin. Uranyl UO22 ions, such as from uranium trioxide or uranyl nitrate and other hexavalent uranium compounds, have been shown to cause birth defects and immune system damage in laboratory animals. While the CDC has published one study that no human cancer has been seen as a result of exposure to natural or depleted uranium, exposure to uranium and its decay products, especially radon, are widely known and significant health threats. Exposure to strontium-90, iodine-131, and other fission products is unrelated to uranium exposure, but may result from medical procedures or exposure to spent reactor fuel or fallout from nuclear weapons. Although accidental inhalation exposure to a high concentration of uranium hexafluoride has resulted in human fatalities, those deaths were associated with the generation of highly toxic hydrofluoric acid and uranyl fluoride rather than with uranium itself. Finely divided uranium metal presents a fire hazard because uranium is pyrophoric. Small grains will ignite spontaneously in air at room temperature. Uranium metal is commonly handled with gloves as a sufficient precaution. Uranium concentrate is handled and contained so as to ensure that people do not inhale or ingest it. Compilation of 2004 Review on Uranium Toxicity. Body System. Human Studies. Animal Studies. In Vitro. Renal elevated levels of protein excretion, urinary catalase and diuresis damage to proximal convoluted tubules, necrotic cells cast from tubular epithelium, glomerular changes renal failure no studies brain, CNS decreased performance on neurocognitive tests acute cholinergic toxicity, dose-dependent accumulation in cortex, midbrain, and vermis, electrophysiological changes in hippocampus no studies DNA increased reports of cancers increased mutagenicity in mice and induction of tumors binucleated cells with micronuclei, inhibition of cell cycle kinetics and proliferation, sister chromatid induction, tumorigenic phenotype bone, muscle no studies inhibition of periodontal bone formation, and alveolar wound healing.